What are you doing? Alex, have you made me sick?
No, I have not. How?
Please just go away. Hi Sheiksters, hi YouTube. Hope you guys are having an amazing week. Today's video is going to be a fall shoe haul. So if you guys have not already seen my first Nordstrom anniversary sale video and then my second Nordstrom anniversary sale try on, make sure to either look above my head or down in the description bar below. Also on my blog, I share my secret and my tips to shopping the anniversary sale. There's only a few days left in the sale, so if you've been thinking about getting some pieces, I highly suggest you check it out now. There will be a direct link down below. Also, if there's some pieces that you wanted that kind of sold out, I would also recommend checking it out right now because sometimes people return items and sometimes they do bring things back. So definitely make sure to check it out. Remember though, the prices go up August 5th. I asked you guys if you wanted me to show you the shoes that I picked up from the sale. I got pretty good feedback. A lot of you are in the same position I am. I actually think I might do a whole dedicated video on like tips and tricks for shopping when you have for finding cute, affordable, on trend, current, whatever you want to say it, shoes at, you know, an affordable price, because I know that the struggle is real. If this is the first time you're seeing my face, hi, my name's Chi-Chi and this is my channel, and our goal here at Supple Chic is to help you style your life better. So please consider subscribing down below. So if you're here to see my shoe scores from the Nordstrom anniversary sale, and of course me try them on, then keep on watching. Shoes is by Mark Fisher. And what makes these super special is that it has pretty much almost the same shape, very 80s. I think the shape is super 80s. I don't know if like the 80s are having a comeback or something, because I'm seeing a lot of shoes that I feel like I could have thrifted like a couple of years ago right now. But it has that conical sort of like shape for the heel. When I first saw these, I thought they were going to be too small for me. I was like, these shoes are tiny. But no, they're not. And like what I like about, you know, investing in my footwear, especially when you get like premium quality, like actual leather, is that the leather has some give to it. It can mold and fit your foot. So if it's something that you know you're going to be wearing a lot and all of the time, I really suggest, and I know not everybody has in their budget to get, you know, real to, you know, splurge on shoes, but if it's a shoe that you're going to be wearing a lot, I really suggest that you get it in leather, because it will fit and mold to your foot beautifully, especially if you have like wider feet like myself. So within like 30 minutes of walking around the house in these just fit my foot so beautifully, so perfectly, so I had no issues. Again, I couldn't tell you. I think this is definitely above a 5 inch. It's probably like a 5.5 maybe. But because of the incline, really, if you cut it, it's about this much of actual heel, okay, that you're standing on, if you guys can see. So this is probably closer to a 3.5 or a 4. It's very pointed toe, you guys already know. It kind of has a lower vamp as well. It comes in several other colors, but I chose this color because I don't have any blue. I think I only have one pair of shoes that's blue, and that has black in it. So I like the fact that this is like all blue. It's a fun pop of color. The cobalt blue looks totally 80s, I know. But it will go with like black. It'll go with... I could also pair it with like my beiges. I could pair it with all my neutrals essentially. So I thought this would be a fun way to like spice up with my winter wardrobe, because I love black, y'all, and I wear it way too much in the winter, fall and winter. So again, this would be a fun way, even with like this jacket, black tank top, or this white tank top, black jeans, these shoes, outfit made. Okay, so the next shoe is from Steve Madden, and this is the boot that I talked about in my shop with me video. These were the boots that are very, very similar to the Louis Vuitton desert boots that pretty much sold out everywhere. People were like on the hunt. It was crazy the way people wanted those boots. And I saw like a lot of stores do dupes for them as well. And Steve Madden did, but they added a little flair, okay? A little sass. And the sass being this leopard print sort of like flap part. Like I said, leopard print is definitely the trend, or not leopard print, but animal print is definitely the trend for fall and winter. So you're gonna be seeing it speckled in different places. But for the most part, I just had to check this boot out for myself. I believe it's real leather. Can you probably get these in like faux leather? Sure. But I think that despite the fact that this is a trendy shoe, it's a style that's very utilitarian, which means you, if you live somewhere that gets like really rough winters, if it gets really cold, if you layer on some like fleece or heavy wool socks underneath these, you will get your wear out of these for a couple of years. I will recommend though that if you are going to invest in this leather shoe, that you also invest in like a leather protector for this, so that it will last you several years, so that the wetness from the snow doesn't, you know, ruin your leather. Again, this chunky platform sort of, I know there's a word for this and it's completely slipping my mind, but this chunky lug sole, that's the word, will get you through all those winters slushing through the snow. And this little, you know, I guess leopard, and this is actually real, like what do they call this one? Pony hair. So this is not even like a cloth. This is real pony hair. So these little accents make this a little bit more premium quality. Oh yeah, it also comes with red laces as well. So if you want to switch out the tan for the red, you can. And it comes in a different color. It comes in black as well. If you do invest in this, I see this lasting you for some time, way past when it's like current or untrend. It will definitely last you. And if you rock this now, you will be, you know, practical and chic. So the next shoe is from Cole Haan. And I just love how like rich this navy is, right? And it is a pair of flats. I actually got this in two colors because I wanted to see for myself. I got this in the red that it comes with. Also got this in this fun leopard print, not leopard, guys, snakeskin. Wow, it's like a pink and a gray, really fun. It has this cute, has the cute bow right here with the little brass nameplate. I believe it says Cole Haan on there. And what really impressed me about this shoe, guys, is this padding that's in here. Honestly, when you put your foot in here, it really feels like you are stepping on just something like marshmallowy, you know, very soft, very cloudy. I really love that addition to it. Cole Haan, of course, is known for its quality shoes. So when I saw that they had included some of their pieces in the sale, I had to grab them. I got them both in a size 12. I don't know what I was thinking. They're both too big. I'm really hoping that they have this in an 11 in the sale so I can try it out for myself. So for my girls who love wearing flats to work, this is a basic. Of course, this color is not a basic. The red one would be more of a basic that you will wear over and over and over again, and it will pay for itself. I did a video on, you know, how to look expensive. You know, you could be wearing a $5 t-shirt from Forever 21. You know, a $5 skirt that you got from the thrift store. But if you have on really nice quality pair of flats with a really nice quality leather handbag and a really nice quality coat, which you could also thrift too. Yes, you could. It just takes your outfit up. Before Meghan Markle became the princess, I looked at her wardrobe and she always had those classic pieces. She always had nice quality flats. She always had nice quality bags, like totes. And then she pretty much wore like the same pairs of jeans. And that was it. That was her. So I knew that I really wanted another pair of leopard pumps. This pair that I picked up from the sale is more of like a camel and black and animal print, because I've been doing my research, is definitely a trend for fall and winter 18. And even if it wasn't a trend, I personally consider leopard a neutral because it just adds a pop of print to your outfits. I love leopard print the way I love tortoiseshell. It works because you can wear it with your light neutrals and with your dark neutrals, except for like gray maybe. They are from the One State brand on Nordstrom, and I got them in a size 11 and 12. I pretty much picked up any shoe that I knew I really liked in both an 11 and a 12. So if you happen to be in a size 12 and any of the shoes that you see in this video are sold out, just DM me. I'll tell you when I'm gonna go return the size 12s that I picked up, and then you could just hurry on over to Nordstrom and be like, they have it at this store. Call them and find out, okay? I picked this pair up, and what I like about it is, of course, the chunky heel. It's a chunky heel, and it's not too high of a heel. Don't ask me how many inches this is. I'm bad at that. I would guesstimate that this is like a 3.5, 4, but, you know, I'll link the shoe down below. I think it gives you all that information on the Nordstrom site. But it also, what I love about it is the fact that it has this like really pointy sort of like cut. I think this is called the vamp. It's a very sexy vamp, a very sexy shoe. It elongates the leg in a good way. And then also has this cutout on the side. I walked around with it. It's very, very sturdy. Even if you're someone like me who can wear heels, who does wear heels, but is such a crybaby, like after an hour, I am totally over it. These shoes would be perfect because they look like shoes that you can wear for at least 2 to 3 hours without like hating yourself. And like somebody put a meme on Instagram where like when you get the, or maybe it was a comment on YouTube, they were like, when you have the wrong shoes on, it just changes your personality. So yeah, these shoes, I definitely, for my working ladies, I would say this is definitely a, if you don't have a leopard pump, I would say, or a comfortable leopard pump, I would say definitely check these out. The next shoe I picked up is another Vince Camuto, and these shoes really, really surprised me. I literally bought them out of curiosity, and I'm so glad I did. So let me show them to you. They are these like cowboy looking boots. They're almost like in a kind of like a gray camel sort of color. They remind me very, very, very much of Isabel Marant. They just remind me of her aesthetic. I'm pretty sure she had a shoe that was this style a couple of years ago. The whole like Western trend always rears its head every season. So I think this shoe is perfect to hit that note. What I like about this shoe, of course, is the heel, because it's a chunky one. It's pointed toe again, so if you have a wider foot, it'll slim it out. And then it also has this dip, which is gonna be very, very sexy, and also creates that illusion of a slimmer, longer foot. These actually got in a size 12. This was probably the only thing that I picked up in a size 12 in this haul that I believe I should have still picked up in a size 12. Why? Because I always have a hard time with this part. I think this is like the shaft, I might be wrong, of the shoe, where it's never wide enough for my foot. By sizing up for these, it is actually wide enough for my foot. And then the next pair of shoes, guys, is a over-the-knee boot. The over-the-knee boot struggle when you are plus size, y'all. When you got big calves like me and wear extended sizes, it's a struggle. It's a yearly struggle. I have a pair of over-the-knee boots that are heeled that I absolutely love, but they're not practical for every day. So I was really looking for a pair, and those ones are from Eloquii, by the way. I was really looking for a pair that would be of a height that I could wear very often. Okay, so this pair is from Steve Madden. And I got this skeptically thinking, oh, this is not gonna fit. I sized up to in a size 11 because I was trying to get as much calf room as I could get. I have pretty wide calves, guys, and this actually fit around my calves. Now, I will not be keeping these because I think, honestly, if I were to get this, I should get this in black because I will probably wear it more than if I got it in this taupe color. But another reason why I'm not keeping these is how you get into them. So it has this little zipper right here on the side, and basically you have to pull this on like a sock. And that's a great idea if you're not a plus size woman. But I feel as a plus size woman, the struggle to get into these shoes, like I'd probably wear them once or twice, or maybe three times the whole winter. And then I probably would need assistance actually to take these off. I needed assistance. So, you know, I'm just telling you straight off the bat, like, if you don't mind that struggle every day trying to put on these shoes, they're totally cute and worth it. What I love about them is the fact that they're pointy like this, again, elongating, and then they have a chunky heel. And this is probably like a 3-inch heel, so it gives you some elevation, which I really like with a over the knee boot. But because it's chunky, you can probably wear this all day if you probably add like some, you know, something like the pedals that you put on the heel. Okay, so the whole thing actually is faux. If you are looking for a shoe, a sock boot, and you're like my size 11-12 and you haven't found one, I will definitely link these down below for you to try on for yourself. And so the next and I think final pair of shoes are these, another leopard print. I told you, did I tell you this was gonna be heavy on leopard? I probably didn't. Are these shoes, and I think these shoes are a perfect transitional shoe between kind of like summer and fall. And they are by the Halogen brand, and I think they also come in several other colors. I always like to have fun with my flats. If I'm gonna wear flats, I like them to be fun. But first, you gotta make sure you have basics, because I got to a point where all my flats were printed and I didn't have a single pair of like solid colored flats. So definitely make sure you have the solid colors first before you go out into the fun prints. But I think having a print really kind of like adds some style points to a simple like everyday work outfit. And so I picked these up. Like I said, they are a great transitional shoe because they are a sling back. They are also pointy, super pointy. They also have that deep V, very elongating to the leg. I got this both in an 11 and a 12, and I decided that the 11 was the true size for me. I'm actually on the fence about keeping these, so I would love you guys to weigh in. Thank you so much for all of the great comments and how you guys weighed in on my try-on haul. Let me know the top 3 shoes you think I should keep from this haul as well, because mama's on a budget. Don't be thinking I'm doing shopping sprees. I'm not. I think this was under 60, if I recall. It's real pony hair. It's real leather. So quality-wise, I think it's worth the price. It also has a little bit of a padding, but I don't know if I love the whole style of the shoe. But something that's like flowy and fun and light and short, this would be perfect for that. You could also pair this with like a fun black dress as well. You could definitely rock these with jeans and like a biker jacket, because it looks very fall from the front, and then you have that little bit of breeze coming through the back. All right, guys, that is it for my shoe haul. Definitely let me know what your top 3 picks are in the comments down below. Let's continue our conversations down there. Let me know what videos you guys, oh God, my bangs. Let me know what videos you guys wanna see me make next. Fall is coming, back to school is coming. What do you guys wanna know more about? I would love, 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 love your suggestions. If you like this video, share it with a friend. Don't forget to rate, comment, subscribe, and share. And until next time, stay blessed. I don't know if it's the 20s when they did the silky dresses, but it is this gorgeous, ruffled,